Hey, and welcome back to episode 2 of Divinity Original Sin 2. We just got off the boat and got attacked by, I guess, a kraken. Looks like it. And we crashed on the seashore here. And I figured out how to rotate the camera with the mouse wheel finally. And I figured out how to quick save and quick load, so now if I die, I can load it faster now. Now we can actually play the game. If we found a waypoint up here called Fort Joy Beach. What is this? A vicious boiling. Probably shouldn't go near it. Wood chip. Go explore. Only autosave. 36 HP, let's not. We only have like 34. 35. Let's go to town and see what's up in here. Candle, the flower pot. Canary. Oh, we found some bowstring. I think we need to get a lucky charm though. Because that allows you to get them off.
Philip builds his throne on the backs of thousands, and the Order lets his statue stand.
Okay. Who down there? Tam? Wait, Tam's a little boy?
The child has a small mirror in his hands. He holds it up at angles, inspecting his eyes, his chin, the crown of his head. He spots you, and his arms snap to his sides.
I'm not supposed to talk to dwarves.
Tell me you've been told not to talk to odd kid.
The child considers your statement.
You're weird. Are you a sorcerer? One of those guys that brings the bad void things here?
Actually, thinks you look like a sorcerer.
The child looks at you straight on, unafraid, searching your face. He lifts his mirror to his nose, closes one eye, and looks at himself again.
I don't see any sauce on you or me. Guess they're wrong or crazy.
Ask the child why he is out here
no
alone.
No one cares where I go. They know I can't leave the island. It's nicer out here than inside anyway.
I can be a parent know where they are.
Now, the magisters took them already. Guess now they're cured. And maybe they're waiting for me back at home.
Say it isn't safe out here. Your ship was attacked by Voidwalken, not far off the shore. Say you survived the Voidwalken attack, but the skin of your teeth, you should really find somewhere safer to go.
There isn't anywhere safer. That's what I mean. You'll see.
Ask him why he doesn't seem scared.
Yes, I am, but it's just normal to be scared. No worries.
Alright, take your leave. A quick save. Heading to town. I'm not going into town because it's broken. Can we go over there? Nope, we can't. Do I have to go through a voidling? I might be able to like sneak by over here. Let's go.
Boring.
Crafting weaponry, died by the sword. A word device, a badly armed, tired knife or shiv if that's all you have. To a stick or a branch, now you got a sword or some sort. Oh, that's cool. Water can be electrified. Who's that? The red print. Oh, he's over here. We'll go talk to him, see what he got to say. Found a pear.
You spot a strange lizard gazing over the water with a steady, malcontent stare. His skin is of a bright blood-red color. Could he be... Yes, you recognize him from the ship. It would seem you're not the only one who survived the tentacles of the deep.
Greet him heartily and say you're glad to see you survived the shipwreck.
The lizard turns about with the graceful ease of a dancer. Or a duelist. You lock eyes with his, two smoldering embers that sizzle your very soul.
I did survive, yes. And chances are I wouldn't have had you not returned to the aid of your fellow passengers down in that dreadful hole. You have my gratitude.
Hand over heart, he salutes you with a bob of the head. More than a nod, though less than a bow.
Tell me you're glad to be a help. Don't do to stand idly by when people are in anger.
Yes, I'm sure you've all the makings of a hero and all that, but let's not get carried away, shall we? Now then, if there's nothing further.
What are you doing here, standing on a rock?
I'm sure I don't mean to sound condescending, but I had thought it quite self-evident I was gazing out over the waves.
He sighs dramatically.
Tell me, what do you see when you cast your glance over this ocean?
So deeply in smile, you see everything.
Or everything. We see much the same then, in our own ways.
He looks out over the water once more, and so do you. A few tranquil moments pass as the waves lap against your thoughts.
As for myself, when I consider this vast expanse before us, I see an empire. I see continents dotted with mighty cities. And shimmering along the soft curve of the sea's horizon, I picture the palaces that formed my paradise. Lost.
What do you mean by lost, exactly?
What do you mean, what do I mean? I mean just what I say. I had a very actual empire that I lost.
Suddenly, having all the air of being deeply offended, he stares at you with utter incredulity.
Well, don't just stand there gawking like an ape at an abacus. Or do you really mean to tell me you don't know who I am? Oh, may the seven have mercy on their own creation. I am the Red Prince, the all-conqueror, the world tamer, the spouse of the sun. Of course you know me.
There's a brief moment's pause, during which his grandiloquent pose deflates ever so slightly.
That said, I suppose I must own up to the fact that I find myself rather in between all-conquering and world-taming opportunities at the moment. The grandeur that is my fate has hit a bit of a snap. But never you worry, for the throne I was destined, and my throne I shall have.
Invite him to travel with you. Maybe you could even help him with the wind back his drone.
Truly. A kind offer indeed. And you've already proven to be trustworthy enough. You came back for the others on that ship, after all. Fine. I accept. On one condition. For reasons I'll not disclose right now, it is imperative that I should meet with a dreamer, one of the mystics of my kind. I've reason to believe one of them may be present on this island. Promise me we'll look for him, and I'll extend you the blessing of my company.
We'll promise him.
So, now that that's settled, first things first. Even if you are as versed in the art of eloquence as I am, that our swords will be doing a lot of the talking from here on out, it goes without saying. As a born fighter, I prefer the perfection of the blade myself. But I'm well acquainted with the secrets of magic, and yes, even subterfuge. What say you?
If a fighter sound perfect, he should stay true to it. That you're interested in someone with little muscle. Could be like a archer. The interesting thumb with a little muscle.
Do not take my elegance as a mask for frailty. My blows shatter shields, and my thrusts pierce armor. If a warrior you need, the warrior you'll have.
I don't know what would be good. I might get a polymorpher. Or a metamorpher. I figure everybody gonna shoot him at a fighter because he has a shield with him. See? He's got a shield on his back. Let's try something different. A battle maid. Say you're after someone who can strike up close but deal damage from afar as well. An executioner, someone who can do a lot of damage up close and personal. A knight would fit the bill. So you're looking for the inquisitor, a fighter who doesn't shy away from dabbling in dark art. And enjoy pummeling his enemies with a heavy two-handed hammer.
Wavering is a sign of weakness, so make your choice and do not take my elegance as a mask for frailty. Wavering is a sign of weakness. Finesse is a condition one should assume in any situation.
Rogue,
dining to
archer,
to dueling.
Shadow
what
blade.
What situations do you have in mind? Wavering is a sign of weakness. Wizardry is embedded in my nature as deeply as the instincts to breathe.
Correct, someone who can kill and support your team.
The dominion over fire suits me best, truth be told, but there is no school of magic I cannot master.
How about we make him... an enchanter.
Very well. Onwards then to victory or death.
The Red Prince nods and gives you a smile that wavers ever so delicately between courtesy and contempt.
Now, as you're aware, you'll be traveling with a prince. Proper forms of address include your majesty, your royal highness, or if you're feeling particularly frivolous, milord. As your luck would have it, I seem to be fresh out of luggage, so you won't be required to carry my belongings.
Okay.
There are other forms of protocol to bear in mind, but I'll see to it and pick up the rest as we go. So, without...
Pull your party portrait apart to unchain them. Breaking the chain stops them from following the party members that are chained to you. Alright, so we'll save here. We've got electric discharge. Hellstrike, Rain, Dragon Blade, Demonic Stare. Drain 6-7 magic armor from target character and gain that amount for yourself. Move that stuff down. Alright. Let's move on over here and see what's over here. I thought it took away his staff. Can we climb there? Knocked down, what?
Black cat. a herald of wisdom in my homeland. How fortuitous.
The cat's eyes are clouded and grey, but it stares at you with acute intensity. Its eyes clear, and it shakes its head, confused.
Okay, so it's gonna follow me now. Great. Nothing there. World secret. Keep an eye out for the secret passageway. Full of hidden. Light would be better. We're going to go down to there. I think now. I'm not exploring it now though. There's a bunch of people up here. Bishop, Magister.
Stay back, sorcerer, and stay silent. Our Godwoken speaks.
We know you've been helping sorcerers escape, Natusa. We have proof.
I'd sooner cut my tongue out than lie to you, Alexander. I know nothing of any escapees.
If you can tell the Godwoken no more, your tongue is of no use. Cut it out.
This can't be serious, Alexander. Come.
You should know by now to obey your superior, Magister, whatever she may ask.
Make it off small and you better not get noted.
Natusa pinches the tip of her tongue with two fingers and brings her dagger to its root. Her eyes squeeze shut. Drops of blood form against the dagger's edge and quickly fall to the ground. She groans.
Stop! My father, may his soul rest in peace, would be disappointed in you, Natusa. To think you would lie to his only son, your bishop, and your friend these many years. The fate of our realm hangs in the balance. If you will not help us save it, then you will help the Void destroy it. Dallas?
Yes, Your Holiness.
I believe we're done here.
Oh, he's got a collar too. And he's got a lot of HP.
Lizard Magister, or what's left of her, lies in a puddle of gore.
She was a lizard, yet a Magister. No matter her reasons, her penalty was fair.
Okay. We looted stuff. Elf can eat limbs with an experiment memory of other people. Okay. Who's over here, brown here? The Yarrow? Can we climb a ladder?
I doubt this.
Bravo. Bottle top.
Hey, looky here, mates. A fresh face. We love fresh faces, don't we? Oh, yes, we do.
Freight arrow.
Why don't you join us in a round of cards? First hands on the house. No problem, Freshy. In that case, enjoy your stay. But I'll be needing to collect your internment fee first, of course. I'm sure the Reds told you. No one gets along without paying the internment fee. So, let's make this easy. Empty your pockets. Well, you've heard of it now, ain't ya? Go on then, Freshy. Turn them out. Go on then. Whatever pennies you've got in your pocket ain't worth my breath. But don't you go telling Griff I was soft on you.
Then come and take your leave. Climate punishment if you take or touch property that is your. Alright. But the litter known as the Red Print,
yeah.
You
know. Ah, grubby, you goblins, the both of you. If you don't like the game,
escape from Reaper's eye.
No, it's just the pair of you and filthy chasing liars don't mean I can't beat you. A little respect for Griff's right hand.
Crate here. See what's in the crate. Word of advice to an unarmed. Find a stick of a brand. Okay. Well, we don't really need to keep what they know. And that. Myra.
The woman is scrabbling at her throat as though she could hardly breathe. She seems to try to make space between her neck and the collar, but there's no space to be made.
Trying to take her collar off. Last floor. Deborah. Wonder where the rest of the curtains are at. Keep on moving. Sam.
To puke yourself to death and get purged.
Not here. Thing now.
What did you say?
That's what happened, isn't it?
Let me go over here. Needle.
So this is
delivery. Surely you'll have one.
What a crumbling disaster.
Or Sylvie. The hatch. We can go down in a little bit.
Amid the squalor of Fort Joy, you suddenly spot an elf with diamond features, regal and radiant, but cold too, and sharper than any knife. She was the one who sat rolling dice in the ship that went under, deciding fates with every roll. Or so she said. Her eyes are focused on a lizard some distance away, and you get the distinct feeling he's an unfortunate man indeed to be trapped in her tiger-like gaze.
Walk up to her and say hello, good to see her again.
No sooner have these words left your mouth than she turns about and grabs you in a stranglehold. You feel the tip of a long needle being pushed a little ways into your neck.
You caught me off guard. No one catches me off guard. Better tell me who you really are, or this time, I'll let my needle do the licking.
Tell the truth, you're the pirate captain known as B.
A seafaring man. Should have known from your barnacle breath.
A push, a pivot, and now you suddenly face her. The needle still all too deeply embedded in the side of your throat. Despite the precariousness of your situation, you notice something that remained undetected in the gloom of the ship. A flaw in her diamond features. A curiously shaped scar on her left cheek.
After how she got the scar?
Let me tell you a little story. Once upon a bad old time, a lizard cut this thing, this living scar, into my cheek. But now I'm free, of sorts. And I've traced that lizard here to Fort Joy. I intend to raise the subject with him.
Politely ask her to remove the needle so you and her can talk this over like civilized people.
No!
She drives the needle in deeper and whispers.
In truth, it does not matter in the least who you really are. You saw me mark my prey. You could warn him, save him, or kill him before I get my chance. That makes you a liability. That makes you needle feet.
Make her an offer instead of killing you. She could join you.
A bright sparkle of laughter follows your proposal.
Ha! How amusing. I admit I had not seen that twist coming. I was certain the pitiful begging was about to begin. Make your case and do it quickly. Why should I join you?
So you're planning your escape and you need people with talent like her.
Escape? How you do tickle me. Most of the misguided dears around here would argue such a thing is impossible.
Assure her you're far from a misguided deer.
I'm inclined to agree. You managed to catch me off guard, after all. Oh, little needle mine, what should I do? Push or pull? You know what? Today is a rather fine day. Sunshine and an easy breeze. Yes, I'll let you live. I'll even agree to travel with you, provided we talk to that lizard I mentioned. I'm not quite sure the weather will save him.
With a casual flick of the wrist, she withdraws the needle from your neck and smiles, as if she just invited you to sit down for tea.
Let's discuss our respective roles then, shall we? You, me, and Death will be playing many a round of hide-and-seek. So, what role would you like me to play? As a rogue, my speciality is stealth, the quick silence of the dagger striking unseen. That said, I'm perfectly lethal, wielding any weapon or magic. So, the choice is yours.
Still, you're interested in someone with a little muscle.
I do enjoy swinging a claymore and seeing heads pop like corks, blood spouting like sparkling wine. If that's the sort of thing you're after.
Say you're like a fighter, someone who can deal plenty of damage.
Suits me fine. Lead on. Or better yet, let me take the lead. Then follow me.
You're not quite certain you'll ever sleep soundly with Sibyl in any sort of proximity. But at least she's on your side for the moment.
Put the party by dragging her out. Here's the goods. Thought you wanted. Dr. Left. Buddy. What's Buddy?
The old dog whimpers sadly.
Crate. Alright, nothing there. Call. Actually. We can go in that cave, but I don't want to. That. I wonder where the rest of the characters are at. I know they're the wizard. I think there's a guy somewhere. Mona. Can't reach. Well, why not? What happened over here? A jar of flour? No idea what that's for. Fort Joy. I can't go that way, I know that. Nebra. Anvil. I talked to her maybe?
Amidst a crowd of screws, bolts, and scraps of metal, the woman is manipulating a glove-like contraption fitted with five long metal skewers. She doesn't look up as you approach.
And what you after?
That's what she's making.
I ain't. Just so you know, it's made. She's clever, Dallas. Made these herself for those bodyguards of hers.
She looks up.
You mentioned a boat. Conjure Incarnation skill book. How much are these? Man, I'm broke.
You looking to buy something?
Take a leave.
Dallas, you maniac. I find I need bread. I want no trouble.
Quick thing.
Teach this beast. He must respect. If not, he comes for you next.
Respect? Someone's got to keep this place running. Griff can't do it for free. Why'd you gotta make this so hard?
An intense-looking man steps between the thug and the elf and rolls up his sleeves, revealing well-muscled and heavily scarred arms.
Just stand aside, won't you, mate? This is no business of yours.
Lone wolves decide their own business.
The thug freezes in fear for a moment before shuffling back to the protection of his crony.
Pay up, elf. No one shorts Griff, especially not one of you.
Pay up, elf. No one shorts Griff. Act.
Runs the kitchen. Means he runs me, you, and everyone else.
Well, the elf owed you
everyone
the money.
Everyone in camp's got to contribute. For food, for protection. No exceptions.
Food? Protection? I have neither.
Then beside the elf and tell the thug to back off.
The intense looking man stands beside you against the thugs, shooting you an appraising glance. Burrow looks you both up and down, sizing up your combined threat.
Ah, get out of here. The both of you. You ain't worth the sweat on my brow anyhow.
The elf smiles and bows to you in thanks.
Follow me, before more of them trouble us. There is a safe place.
The safe place to escape. Oh, cool. You just gained a level pressed eye to enhance your stats and ability. Okay, so. I don't know if I want to get him another character or go at the other the female character. The escape. We heard of some sort of gang leader called the Griff. Perhaps someone like him would know. Oh wait, okay. Shall be joining my party. It seems she is very adamantly wants to question a certain leader. She and her needle are clearly not to be trifled with. Makes me wonder what'll happen. We find the ones you seek. Okay. I guess we'll talk to this guy.
The man rolls his sleeves back down. He nods at you, the shadow of a smile on his lips.
Good work there. Good work. I can tell.
He stretches out one rough hand to shake yours.
Myron reached out a hand to shake her.
He grips your hand tight as a vice and shakes it hard.
Good to meet you, lad. Say, you don't look all that busy. I could use someone to watch my back. And it looks like you could use someone to watch yours. I've just got a small errand to run. And then I'll be looking to get the hell out of here while I've still got a neck to collar. How about we stick together until we get out of this place?
Say the thugs were afraid when you mentioned Lone Wolf. What are they?
He shrugs, looking off to the side.
Mercenaries. It's a job. My job.
Ask him about the errand he mentioned earlier. Stone. Highly suspicious.
Everyone needs to make a living. I make mine running errands.
Ash, who is he here to kill?
He shoots you a flinty look, old teeth and peril.
Lone wolves only share such information with friends. Are we going to be friends? No
harm
having a friend in this place. One hand washes the other and all that. Trust me, there'll be plenty of filth to wash off around here. But suit yourself.
Let's just stick together for now.
He grins, sharp teeth glittering in the midday sun.
So, before we hit the road, it's best if we decide battle strategies up front. Should keep more of our blood in. Survival's my main priority. I'll use every trick in the book to keep us alive. But if a wayfarer's not what you're after, I've got other skills. What do you need?
I got a fighter. Got a mage and a metamorpher. I don't know what'd be good. We're even a chantry, isn't it? I don't know where to put him at. It was an enchantress, wasn't it? Talent. You know, you're a fighter. To make this other character, 1 point would add 7% vitality. Wit, 1 point would add 1% critical chance plus 1 initiative. Okay. I think you're in the hand. Is there a way to see what? A selector.
Too much, you might say. I can make them bleed any which way you want. Which is?
You got a fighter. They're looking for an inquisitor, a fighter who doesn't shy away from dabbling in dark art, and enjoy pummeling his enemy with a heavy two-handed hammer.
Sure, think it up. What good's an outlaw who can't command the shadows? I've dabbled enough to know I've an affinity for the darker arts, but I'm a quick learner. What's your preference?
Okay, the leader of an enchanter. So you're in need of a cleric, someone who can heal and support your team.
Sure, think it up. Dexterous arts. What are you looking for exactly?
A rogue.
A tapestry embroiderer.
What about my character? The avatar to be should. A metamorph.
Sure, think it can do. Onwards, sure, think it up.
I don't want him in a wayfarer.
Time in the world to rot in here. Too much, you might say. I can make them bleed any which way you want. Which is?
Looking for an inquisitor with a fighter who doesn't shy away from dabbling in dark art.
Can do. Onwards.
He scans the horizon for threats with one green eye, then nods back at you.
Right you are. Lead the way.
Okay, so now we got a full party now. Electric discharge, healing potion, all in. Summon, I think, Thorwolf? Summon your trusty Thorwolf which can howl and bite enemy. Oh, you got a wolf you can summon. You got break the shackle. Chilled up. Okay, alright, you have to unlock. Move it down. Battle stomp. Bounce and chilled. Fortify. Provide 12 physical armor while fortified. The target cannot be teleported. Remove poison, bleeding, burning after it gets paid. Okay. Alright. Alright, cool. Now we're gonna hit, I think, home. After that happened, F5, a quick save. Where's she at?
Hey, I know you.
Losa, the dark-eyed jokester you met aboard the ship, waves enthusiastically and dips into a mock elegant curtsy.
Back then I was Madame Josephine Gribbles de Pube. And you were the Beast, right? Glad to see you made it. Nothing like a nice tentacle slap across the moor to set the tone for the week, eh? How'd you escape? Me too. Did you hear something? When you were in the water, I mean.
Nah, tell her there was a strange voice that seemed you wanted to hurt his vibe.
I heard the same thing.
That's weird.
Do you know what this means? It means I'm not the only.
Losa's voice catches in her throat. The joy drains from her face. Her eyes lose focus and her whole body goes rigid. She is stock still, waxy skinned, her eyes dark. Grayish black veins run from her eyes down her cheeks.
Gently call out to her and ask if she's alright.
Her head snaps to you mechanically, and her eyes lock with yours, dark pupils dilated into great black voids.
Well.
Light suddenly flashes back into her face. The gray veins drain to pinkish flesh, and her whole body relaxes.
Anyway, what were we talking about?
Tell you we're discussing the shipwreck.
Yeah. It was a shipwreck, all right. Not much more to say about it, I guess. Papa Joris used to tell me, Losa, he'd say. Losa, you ever find yourself in a sinking ship, follow the rats. They'll find you a way out. Applies to a lot of situations, actually. Vermin tend to know what's what.
I hope you can explain what you were doing just a moment ago.
Oh, it's nothing really. It's just, I'm just a bit, well, a bit hospitable.
Or she's going to have to elaborate.
Put it like this. You've never been a host, I bet. That's because you're an infested clump of leaves on the side of the road. That ain't bad, though. I'd give just about anything to be like you. But I'm a roadside inn. Red door, flowers out front, friendly lady at the door beckoning you in for half price. Like a goddamn gold star inn for the disembodied.
Actor, how many beings she is hosting at the moment?
Feels like just one, strangely enough. Big one, though. Don't know its name yet, either. It takes time for them to get comfortable and introduce themselves. So, how are you enjoying the joy?
Did the magistrate hold you in something about being a danger to yourself and society?
Yeah, same story here. Reckon in my case, they might actually be right, though. So, you want to check this place out together? Strength in numbers and all that. It does, right? Before we head out, I've got more than a few tricks up my sleeve. So you'll have to pick which one I'll pull out if, when, push comes to shove. Lately, I've been into the enchanting arts, but I can shoot, slash, summon. Don't know if you could tell, but mysticism's kind of my speciality. Let's get into the nitty-gritty while we're at it. What's up? Sounds fine. So, we're good to go?
We're like a cleric.
Hey, wait a sec. It looks like you have all the company you need. Maybe another time, when you're a bit more on the lonely side. Till then.
Alright. We got a full party finally. Who is Painted of Lucian?
The shrine depicts Lucian the Divine, avatar of the seven gods. A low, resonant vibration hums somewhere deep within you. Your knees buckle. The hum grows louder. The world tilts and fades.
Shrine by the looks of it.
Okay. Looks like a waypoint. Who's that, Womp? Guy I gotta talk to. Camp Boss Griff.
Worse than war ration.
Griff is slowly, methodically peeling the skin from a potato. As you approach, he looks up, setting the potato, but not the sharp little knife, down on the table.
What?
Ain't a biter? Nope. Actually, he's in charge around here.
Who's asking?
They're just a fellow inmate and had some questions.
He smirks and holds the little knife up to the light, watching it glint.
I'm listening.
Say you heard he's a good friend to have, and actually, if there's anything he can help you with.
He points the tip of his blade at the grisly sight of the elf hunched over, clutching his knees in the cage.
I solve my own problems.
Actually, if you know this thug, are terrorizing the camp citizen.
Thugs. Look at it this way. People get lawless here, and we all starve.
So you're looking for a way out of the place.
Can't help you there. If I could, I wouldn't be here peeling goddamn potatoes.
That's what he knows about the magistrate and the cure for the sorcerer.
Well, they'll cure you of your sauce. Nightshade will cure you of an headache too.
Nightshade? Alright, so we got her. Found I found it in Fort George. He joined up with me. He's a member of the mercenary band called the Lone Wolf. And he's needing to get out of here as soon as he completes the contract. I should ask him about it.
Tired of the view in here yet?
Wonder about that little errand he mentioned. Who exactly is that?
Ifan shrugs off his backpack and reaches into its depths. After rummaging around, he holds out a tattered page to you, upon which you can see a broken wax seal in the shape of a wolf's paw.
Have a read of my contract and find out.
The target is none other than the Divine Bishop Alexandrar, leader of the Divine Order. They call for show our benefactor, or the Silver Claw is the most feared among all the Lone Wolf. For some aid with your mission, seek Magister Boris in the ghetto. Seek our model. May the moonlight. Okay.
So, time to find this Boris fellow. Ah, you've read my contract. What does that look in your eye mean?
Beam at your statement and say we're killing.
He raises an eyebrow and folds his arms, appraising you.
Me, not you. It's my contract. But you can come along for the ride.
Nah, it won't be easy but your help.
Good to know. And likewise, with whatever errands of your own you have.
Right click and examine a company. A companion check their current attitude towards you. Be aware. Companions who really don't like you will leave your party. You can recap off trail. Okay. Well, that kind of sucks if they leave the party. What is that if you lose all the equipment to have on? A quick save.
The ravaged among the ruins. That is all we are in Fort Joy.
Actually, what our next move to
we
be.
We may see no bars, but we are firmly behind them here and now. As I hunt for answers, escape must ever be on our minds. Ha! Nonsense. We've already cheated death coming here. We have but to cheat the living to leave. Ha! Shouldn't be too hard, trust me. May require some needlework, though. Let's save those for later, shall we? Not quite the thing I tend to share with strangers.
Take your leave. Alright, let's move out here. What is the Griff? Magister Bora? Save it. Metamorphosis. There you go with. Currently strength based attack can go do 10% more, 10% extra damage. Magic armor absorbs magical damage. As long as your magic armor is above zero, you're immune to magic that is like burning and stun. Two in strength. two-handed. Increased damage and critical modifier when using a two-hand melee weapon. Sword act beer made. Okay. Leadership grants dodging and resistance bonus to all allies in a 5-meter radius. Next level 3, put 50% damage. Okay. Lord Master identified enemies and allows you to identify items. Increasing Lord Master allows you to identify more faster. Sneaking. Sneaking determines how well you can sneak without getting caught. I think I'm gonna level up. Probably persuasion. I don't know. We'll do a lucky charm because I'm probably gonna do most of the looting with this character. Oh, he didn't level up. I do constitution with her. Get some more health. Retribution reflect receive damage to your attacker. Increase damage and exit when you know. Yeah, we gotta use that. Gotta be able to hit the guy. Lord Master identified enemy. Okay, I think we really don't need more than one right now. We'll just go with bartering. Arrow increase all air damage you deal. Increase all water damage you deal in any vitality, healing, or magic armor restoration that you call. Water type deal 5% more damage for 5. I'm gonna do it. Preserve. Restore magic armor after recover from frozen or stun. Restore physical armor after knockdown or petrified. We'll go with scoundrel. Increase movement speed and boost your critical modifier. Holy crap. Thumbing. Thumbing increase vitality damage, physical armor, and magical armor. Just thumbing and totem. Warfare increased all physical damage you deal. So we'll go with good air. And for it. One point telekinesis. Currently intelligent base attack go do 10% extra damage. How many? Base slot 4. Extra slot from memory. Plus 1 point equals 1 slot. So. Okay. 1 point equals 5% increased damage. We do intel. All right. Okay. Alright. We're gonna stay over here. And that'll be the end of this episode. Like and subscribe. Next episode we'll move on to, I guess, the quest and try to figure out what more is going on. Thanks and bye.